If you drive a car, you're probably aware that the price of petrol has been skyrocketing. You've probably also heard that the government has responded by halving the fuel excise for the next 6 months. But while cutting the fuel excise may offer short-term reprieve from high petrol prices if it gets passed on to the consumer, it does nothing to address Australia's dependence on imported foreign oil and little to alleviate the long-term cost of living pressures on everyday Aussies. Australia is almost entirely reliant on imported oil to power its transport system, and there's no long-term plan in place for transport security or decarbonisation. One measure that would see savings on fuel costs for households across Australia and reduce transport emissions is the introduction of mandatory fuel efficiency standards. Fuel efficiency standards are a common way of regulating vehicle efficiency, lowering fuel consumption and carbon dioxide emissions. In fact, Australia is one of the only OECD countries that doesn't have them. Fuel efficiency standards are usually measured in grams of CO2 per kilometre and, importantly, are set at the fleet level. That means that for a vehicle manufacturer to meet the standards and avoid penalties, the average fuel efficiency across all their car models is what is assessed. In practice, this tends to mean that efficient and electric vehicles get sent to markets or countries with fuel efficiency standards in place, and Australia ends up as a dumping ground for inefficient gas guzzlers, leaving Australians buying more fuel than they should be. It's important to note that fuel efficiency standards are different to emission standards, which regulate the other nasty pollutants that come out of the tailpipe, like carbon monoxide and particulate matter. They're also different to fuel quality standards that regulate the quality and sulfur levels of the fuel itself. Australia does have emission standards in place, equivalent to Euro 5 standards, but they're well below the standards that are set in comparable countries. Australia doesn't have any mandatory fuel efficiency standards, and that's why our cars are so inefficient compared to other countries. The 2022 International Energy Efficiency Scorecard ranks Australia third last on transport efficiency out of 25 of the world's largest energy users. It's no wonder that the introduction of fuel efficiency standards has been recommended time and time again by Australia's Climate Change Authority, ministerial forums, private members' bills, Senate committees and House committees. It's also a policy that two-thirds of Australians support. So if we're serious about long-term fuel savings, reducing transport emissions and encouraging efficient and electric vehicles, then fuel efficiency standards are a good place to start.